Hello guys, so welcome to my new Genshin Impact video. Guys, the real Tesley, the most awaited character of the 4.1 patch, 4.1 is coming and everyone is talking about real Tesley. So in this video we are gonna talk about the real Tesley being a most reliable DPS on the field or not. So stay tuned till the end guys, we're gonna talk about in detail whether it's worth wishing on real Tesley or not. So first of all, why everyone's just comparing Ryo Tesley to Deha? Because they have similarities in the kit, in the gameplay. So what are the similarities? First of all, they both deal damage in normal attacks. When you activate elemental skill of Ryo Tesley, you perform lots of normal attacks for 10 seconds and you deal only damage in normal attacks. And when you activate the elemental burst of Deha for 4 seconds, you only deal damage in normal attacks. So they are performing and they are dealing maximum damage in their normal attacks. And also the second reason is the HP. They both have something with the HP. Increasing or decreasing HP will give them some amount of buff, and they are having a full HP build where Ryo Tesley is not built on the basis of HP. They have so many similarities, even their damage percentages are actually same. Yes, surprisingly, their damage percentages are actually same. If you see here, the Ryo Tesley on level 10 elemental skill having a normal attack of 170% normal attack damage, where if you compare this normal attack damage with the Deha's normal attack damage, it's literally the same. The 177.7% with the max HP mode. That means Deha's having more damage in normal attacks if you compare it with the Ryo Tesley. So Ryo Tesley having a lesser damage, the dealing damage, if you compare with Deha in terms of the multiplier. These are the damage percentages and multipliers, not the actual dealing damage. But yes, Ryo Tesley is falling behind in terms of the percentages. If you compare that one time damage, that Ryo Tesley having 228 damage when he activated his elemental burst, if you compare this to Deha's, actually low. They are having 250. So here also, Ryo Tesley is falling way behind. Keeping aside all the percentages, the Ryo Tesley is better in many departments. Like, there's many characters in the game that are stats gonna be very good if you pair them with the Ryo Tesley. And second thing is the speed of the normal attacks. Speed of the normal attacks, they are having way slower speed of the normal attacks if you compare with the Ryo Tesley. Ryo Tesley is faster in every possible way. The whole gameplay and everything feels way faster if you compare right with Deha or any other character that uses fist and deals damage in normal attack. The fastest in the game currently is the Xeno, and I think Ryo Tesley can give a really good competition in terms of the normal attack speeds to Xeno. But talking with the Deha, comparing the attack speed, the gameplays, capabilities, the team capabilities, the artifacts capabilities, the weapon capabilities, Ryo Tesley is better in all departments if you compare right with Deha. Beside that guys, both having different visions. Ryo Tesley carries the cryo vision and Deha carries the pyro vision. Why I'm mentioning that? Pyro is highly dependable on the vaporize and melt damage, whereas cryo is not dependable on the reaction damage. We have Ayaka before, we have Ganyu before. They both are pretty good, very top tier damage dealer in the game, and those both characters are not dependable on the reaction damage. Like Ayaka and Ganyu both deals a pure raw cryo damage without any reaction, like there is no melt reaction, and still those two characters are pretty good. I think same scenario is gonna happen with Ryo Tesley. Ryo Tesley is also not meant for the reaction damage. He is gonna be a pure raw cryo damage dealer, and in that case, we've already seen previously two characters, two DPS characters that performs brilliantly in the game. So I think that same scenario is gonna happen with Ryo Tesley. Whereas all the pyro character we have in the game, all are dependable on the reaction damage, but with the kit of Deha not seems to have that potential of being a good DPS. Why? First of all, I didn't like the normal attack attack duration is only 4 seconds. 4 second duration is very less for a character who only deals damage in the normal attacks. Like, you're performing normal attacks just for 4 seconds only, and that's it. Beside that, you're not dealing any kind of damage. Like, in the elemental skill also of Deha is not dealing very that amount of damage, and I just really don't understand the elemental skill, the motive of the elemental skill of Deha, whereas Ryo Thessaly is just dealing the damage, not doing any other thing. In the ultimate, he performs a AoE attack, AoE cryo attack, just similar to Ayaka, similar to Ayaka elemental burst. And also in elemental skill, he's performing normal attacks for 10 seconds. Yes, guys, for 10 seconds. So he's just purely dealing damage in all the abilities, from normal attacks to elemental skills to elemental burst, where Deha is only dealing damage, proper damage in elemental burst for 4 seconds. That's what makes Deha weaker. Also, Deha's capability of doing the reaction damage is also very weak if you compare to any other Pyro character. The attack speed of Deha's normal attack is slower if you compare it with the Ryo Thessaly. And guys, there are many weapons, there are many catalyst 5-star weapons in the game that just boosted your movement speed or attack speed by 10% or 20%. Like, there's 3 weapons in the game. First is the Scaramouche signature weapon, Tulla Tulla Remembrance. It increases the attack speed by 20%. Then there is a signature weapon of Ryo Thessaly. It increases the attack speed by 10%. And there's one more weapon in the game, the OG weapon, Lost Pedro's Sacred Wind. It also increases your movement speed by 10%. So guys, you're gaining more attack speed by these weapon if you use one of these weapon, any of these weapon. But in the case of Deha, we do not have any weapon specifically who just boosted your, you know, movement speed or attack speed. And if you're talking about a default attacking speed of both of these characters, Ryo Thessaly is faster in terms of performing normal attack compared to Deha, guys. Oh yeah, so overall Ryo Thessaly is gonna be very good character in the game. I'm super excited to, you know, just wish on the Ryo Thessaly and, you know, just smash some heads with Ryo Thessaly. And guys, I covered everything. If still you have any question related to Ryo Thessaly, whether he's gonna be good or not, or artifacts or team, I already have created the video related to artifacts, weapons and teams. You can go on my channel and check it out. And still, after watching all the videos, if you still have any question, you can ask me in the comment, no problem. If you like the video, please hit the like button and share this video with your friends. If you want to watch more amazing Genshin content in the future, subscribe to my channel. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.